Quazi here, and in this video, I'm going to share with you a very, very powerful technique called the Deity Creation Technique from the Identity Shifting Paradigm to help you create the version of yourself that will accelerate your achievement of your goals. Before I begin this video, I wanted to quickly announce that I'm doing a free giveaway of my book, Life Mastery. If you want to enroll into a competition to win this book for completely free at the end of the week in the ebook format, just comment Life Mastery down below. Also, I'm excited to announce that the free one-to-one consult for the Reality Mastery program is still open. And if you want to understand how you can get your free one-to-one consult, wait till the end of the video. So with that, let's get started with this video. Now in this video, I want to share with you a powerful technique called the Deity Creation or the Deity Creation Technique. I'm not too sure how to pronounce this, but please forgive me if I'm pronouncing it incorrectly. But I'm going to be sharing with you this technique that I've been doing in the Reality Mastery program with my clients to get extremely, extremely crazy results with, you know, all of this stuff, even in my personal life, that's for sure. Now, if you didn't know what identity shifting is, it's what I offer in the Reality Mastery program. It's essentially, I saw that anything that I wanted in my life came as a result of who I became, not what I wanted, not what I did, but you know, it was first being and then doing and then having. So there were three paradigms to manifestation, and the most powerful paradigm is the becoming paradigm. Not the having paradigm, not the doing paradigm, but the becoming and the being paradigm. Once I started to apply this into my personal life and fully incorporate systems and techniques into this whole system, I saw that any area of my life that I wanted to become successful in, I could systematically become successful in it. I put the system in, boom, within 2 to 3 months, it would come into place. Put the system in again, boom, within maybe 6 to 8 weeks, it would come in. So it depends, you know, the time, it always happens when it's right, but it eventually happens, that is confirmed. So with that said, let's talk about this Deity Creation Technique and how you can use this to completely transform your life. What I want you to understand is that in Hinduism, they always had deities. You know, they always had deities or deities, and they would worship these deities. Now, they had a different one for different areas of life. Because if you really think about it, whenever you're hungry, if you were in a desert and you were really hungry, or if you're really thirsty, and God came, you wouldn't give a shit about God. You'd be like, okay, well, is there food? Can he bring me food? Can he bring me water? So then at that point, water and food become your God. Whenever you're tired, then sleep becomes your God. Whenever you're poor, then money becomes your God. Whenever you're, you know, not attractive, then attractiveness becomes your God. Whenever you're not getting what you want, the thing that you want is what becomes your God. So in Hinduism, they have many different gods for every single area of life. They have, you know, gods of health, gods of wealth, gods of, you know, relationships, you name it. They have a god for almost everything. That's why there are so many different Hindu deities. Now, with that said, this is a very, very powerful way of creating a 2.0 version of yourself using this Deity Creation Technique. So essentially, the idea of this identity shifting principle, this identity shifting technique, is to create a 2.0 version of yourself that is fit to effortlessly manifest whatever it is that you want in your life. Because if you really think about it, the current character you are right now, who you are right now, is definitely not fit to achieve your dream life. It is 100% fit to live the life that you're living right now. And as a result of that, it is living this life. But the character that you need to become, that you haven't become yet, is not fit to achieve whatever it is that you want. And the unfortunate reality is that the nature of our goals, the nature of our desires are infinite. Once we get something, we'll want the next thing. Once we get the next thing, we'll even want the next thing. So life is always in a state of unfolding and becoming. Nothing will ever be its ultimate potential. Once you become 2.0 Quazi, you'll become 3.0 Quazi. You'll want to become 3.0 Quazi, 4.0, 5.0. You're going to want to keep up-leveling your life every single day because that is just the nature of life. This is just the nature of our desires. The key distinction is our desires are infinite, but we're chasing it in the finite realm. So you'll never really stop until you get a taste of the infinite. You know, your wishes and desires are infinite, but you want $1 million and then 1 million and one, 1 million and two, 1 million and three. This is just finite. You can keep counting numbers all you want, but you'll never reach the infinite that way. So the nature of our desires are infinite, and you know, we're chasing it in the finite realm. And that's why most people get into spirituality, because spirituality is, you know, a taste of the infinite. Once you start to fully contemplate things beyond this life and you realize 100% that this life is limited and it will end soon, you know, it's not forever, then you want to seek that which is forever, that which will last forever, that which is infinite. So in this technique, I want to share with you how to create a deity for yourself, a 2.0 version of yourself, so that you can become that version of yourself that you need to be in order to achieve your worldly goals. And now, before I even go further with this video, I want to make sure that you've watched the previous video, which is called the imitation technique, which is also something that I teach in the Reality Mastery program. So definitely click up here to check out the imitation technique. Essentially, what the imitation technique is I found that whenever I, you know, wanted to improve in a certain area of my life, I had mentors for it. And not just mentors that I interacted with, but mentors that I followed, mentors that have shared their works online and on YouTube, and mentors that I've just looked up to. And as a result of following those mentors, I saw that I started taking up the qualities of those mentors. And I started asking myself, oh, what would, you know, George Clooney do when he's talking to this attractive girl? How would George Clooney act? Or how would Brad Pitt do this? Et cetera, you know? Whatever area of life that you want to succeed in, if you start to find out mentors and people who've already had the kind of success that you want, people that you resonate with and look up to, and you start to imitate their qualities, then you will become successful like them. So make sure you check out the imitation technique. It's a very, very powerful way to go about doing this. And it also forms the basis of the deity creation technique. So with that, let's get started with this exercise. So this exercise is very simple. It's just three steps. Step one, what you want to do is find 5 mentors in different areas of your life. And again, it's important that you find 5 people who you resonate with and you think you could, you know, become them and imitate the qualities of them, but rather you want to, you know, not copy everything word for word, but rather take the qualities that they have and implement them for you, for yourself. So take 5 mentors in 5 different areas of life. Let's say you have fitness goals, then you find people in fitness, you have wealth goals, you find people in wealth, you have relationship goals, you find people in relationships, you have spirituality goals, people in spirituality. Let's say you have certain character goals and you look up to someone who's in personal development, like Tony Robbins, and you start to imitate Tony Robbins' qualities, like, oh, well, what would Tony Robbins do? Okay. And if you're a female, maybe you want to find someone else you can relate to with those qualities. I'm not sure if you can imitate female qualities. Maybe you can. I've never tried it because, or for some reason, I've always gravitated towards male mentors because I can sort of resonate with them. So it's important that you resonate with the mentors that you're going to imitate. So let's say for fitness, I always had Kino Body and I always imitated him at the gym. You know, I was like, oh, what would Kino Body do? Okay, he's gonna work out 3 days a week. Okay, I'm gonna try working out 3 days a week. How would he, you know, conduct his exercises? You know, what would he feel? What would he do? Et cetera, et cetera. So like imitating the qualities the best way I can. Then for wealth, you know, I had people like Sam Ovens. Like, oh, what would Sam Ovens do for his business? Okay, cool. What would this other person do? What would that other person do? Okay, how would he conduct his day-to-day living when he's working, when he's at work, etc., etc.? So that was very, very powerful for me as well. And then for other areas of life, I had other mentors. So make sure you also have 5 different mentors, or at least 5 different mentors in different areas of your life that you want to improve in. So just to state the areas again, there's always going to be, you know, spirituality, wealth, health, relationships, and your personal character, and just in general, things that you bring to yourself to enrich and become better and better every single day. So character goals. Next, what you want to do is after you find out these 5 mentors, you want to craft this 2.0 version in their image. So maybe you write down certain traits. Maybe you write a short paragraph about the traits that the 2.0 version of yourself has. And make sure you make this creative as possible, as creatively as you can. Because the more creative energy you can get out of this, the better. And you know, this exercise is directly from the Reality Mastery program. So make sure you're taking advantage of this and make sure you start using it because it's very, very powerful. I have never shared this before. So you want to write down a short paragraph of the traits and the strengths that your character has. Another short paragraph about the appearance and how this character conducts itself every single day. So in this way, you're going to be crafting your 2.0 version, the version that you need to be. And also write another short paragraph, by the way, on what this character has and achieves. So the achievements of this character. Remember, the three things you want to be writing paragraphs on: traits and strengths. Next is the personal appearance, how this character presents itself to other people, other characters, in its environment. What sort of things it wears. You know, for me, I always, you know, I put my character with a little wristwatch. I always like to wear something very simple. I always like to wear joggers. And also I like to, I always see myself with a golden ratio physique, you know, at 190 pounds with a waist to shoulder at golden ratio. And then finally, you want to write down a short paragraph of the character's achievements and what this character has, what kind of car it drives, you know, what kind of house it lives in, blah, blah, blah. All of these three things. And then in step three, what you want to do is form a mental image of your ideal character in its ideal environment. So a series of different slides, and you want to embellish them, really embellish them. So at first you begin seeing this character in its ideal environment and almost using the pure technique to shift into its body. So if you don't know what the pure technique is, click up here. And it's a sort of meditation from a book called Parallel Universes of the Self by Frederick Dodson. So it's a very, very powerful technique to shift into your ideal 2.0 version. Make sure you do this. So create your ideal self in its ideal destination, in its ideal life, in its ideal reality. And keep visualizing and turning that slide and shifting into the body of your ideal self. Maybe once every week, once every day, whatever you feel. And the pure technique will help you do just that. So those are the three steps. Just to recap this video, understand that every time, you know, Hindu deities were made, it was because someone lacked something and wanted something. So they created a form that has these things that they want. Understand that there were different deities for different aspects of life. There is God for wealth, God for health, God for food, God for water. Anytime you don't have something, that thing becomes your God. Identity shifting is about crafting that 2.0 version of yourself, the version that is fit and worthy to effortlessly live your dream life. And with the deity creation technique, there are three steps. First of all, you have to find five mentors that you can sort of resonate with and also has the qualities that your ideal character needs and the things that you want to achieve in your life. Number two, you want to craft this 2.0 version by writing down three paragraphs, a short one for its traits and strengths, a short one for its personal appearance, and a short one for its personal achievements. So this 2.0 character, how does it live its life? You know, what does it do every single day? How does it present itself? And what sort of strengths and traits does it need to have in order to get to this point? Like, why did it get to this point? And then number three, you want to form a mental image of your ideal character in its ideal location and sort of use the pure technique to shift into the body of its ideal character. The more and more you keep doing this, the more and more you'll become this ideal self every single day. One morning you'll wake up and because this change is so gradual, you'll be like, oh wow, I've actually become this ideal self. It's crazy how this is going to work. And the more and more out of alignment you get off this character, the more uncomfortable you'll get. You'll come to a point where it'll be like, for me, you know, I see myself with 190 pound superhero physique. When I don't go to the gym for a day, I'm like, oh God, this just doesn't feel right, not going to the gym. When I don't do my morning yoga for a day, just like, oh, this doesn't feel right. You know, I'm not being my ideal character. So remember that life is always in a process of becoming and unfolding. And it doesn't matter who you are right now, but rather what you are becoming every single day. Nothing will ever be its ultimate potential, but rather will constantly evolve into something else. Once you achieve $1 million, you're going to want 1,000,001. This is the infinite nature of your desires. Our desires are infinite, but what we are chasing is the finite. What we're chasing is the $1 million, the 1,000,001, the 1,000,002. So that's why this hunger will never be fulfilled unless you reach the divine. So make sure you also watch the reference videos for this video, which is the imitation technique. So click up here to look at the imitation technique video and to learn how to use this in your life, because this is a very, very powerful way to sort of influence that change in your subconscious so that you can empower yourself to shift into that 2.0 version of yourself by imitating the qualities of your mentors and people who already have what you want. So with that, I conclude this video. I sincerely hope this helped. If you enjoyed this, make sure you leave me a comment and also leave me any questions that you have down in the comment section below. If you're new to the channel, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell, because believe it or not, for some reason, if you don't hit the bell, you're not notified of any new video that I put out. So make sure you hit the bell for exciting new videos to come out and also things that'll help you supercharge your manifestation. And finally, I'm super excited to announce that I'm growing a massive Facebook group where I'll be sharing all of this kind of stuff. So make sure you participate in that and also take advantage of this group, because we'll be helping you achieve your goals. And also you'll be having access to a like-minded community of people who are serious about all of this stuff. The Reality Mastery Program is open for enrollment. And as I mentioned before, the Reality Mastery Program is focused on the principles of identity shifting and the becoming paradigm. Because what I found in my personal life was that whenever I shifted into the ideal version of myself, boom, I got whatever it is that I wanted in my life. And I saw that I could turn this into a systematic process for goal achievement. Anything that I got in my life was all a result of who I became. Anything that I've helped my clients get in their lives and achieve and manifest in their lives and actually keep it, was because of what they have become. You know, people can get money, but they can't keep it. You'll see people winning the lottery, but they won't be able to keep the money. Because it doesn't matter how much money you make, it matters how much money you get to keep. So becoming is all a part of sustainably, you know, attracting this thing into your life and improving every single day and growing every single day. That's why I teach identity shifting. That's why I apply it in my personal life. And that's why I've used it so efficiently, so much in my personal life. Now, I saw that whenever I became the attractive version of myself, boom, I got my ideal partner came into my life. The fit version of myself, boom, I got into the best shape of my life. Whenever I shifted into the entrepreneur version of myself, boom, I got the results that I wanted in my business. And I know all of this is possible for you as well, because I'm helping my clients do this every single day in their lives. So if you're interested in this, make sure you click on the link in the description below to sign up for the free one-to-one consult while it's still available. It'll take around 45 minutes to an hour long to diagnose your current law of attraction practices and to see how you can implement identity shifting into your life right now, and to see if it would be a good fit to work together and help you get the transformational results that you want in your life. I know what it's like to live the groundhog day every single day and feel like you're hitting a brick wall in all of your efforts, but identity shifting, shifting your reality, will literally unblock and get you unstuck right now. So make sure you take advantage of this opportunity. Thank you for watching. Till next time, peace.